To make the stiles and rails, we need to start over again and do rough cuts. So your dimensions are your lengths 14 and 11. So I'm gonna need one piece 14 and two pieces 11. I'll explain why kind of as we go along. So again, get your board out of the back and check it for defects. Now this one, you can't see it on the film, but there's a crack all the way down to here. So I'm gonna cut off quite a bit because I have to get rid of this crack all the way down. And then please throw it away. Throw it out of the way. Nobody wants the crack in their board. There, I can see the end of the crack there, and I get rid of it. So 14 and 11. And I want two of them. Now make sure that the board you grab is at least 5.5 to 6 inches wide. That way I can get two pieces out of my long ones. Now we do our cuts for width. Now here's the widths. Most of them are 2.5 inches wide. So I'll set it to 2.5. And my long piece, I will get two 2.5 side by side. Those are the two on the left and the right. Now, on this one, it's a style, so it goes horizontally. I need one for the bottom at 2.5, but I also need one at 4.5. Now, the other at 4.5 has this cathedral cut, that's why it's extra wide, but I don't have enough to get a 2.5 and a 4.5. That's why I got another piece. So let's cut up the 2.5s. Do a short one at 2.5. And there's enough left that somebody else can use this for their door if they need. Then we move it out to 4.5 and cut again. So now if I put these together, I'll have my two styles and my two rails, and that's how the door will be put together. I just have to cut up the cathedral. Now we come back to the upcut saw to cut length. Now again, I could cut all of the end cuts, all the length cuts on a chop saw, which is fine. But the reason that I prefer the upcut saw is because my chop saw doesn't go down to 9 3/4, which is the length of the short ones. So let's do them in order. The long ones are going to be 12 3/4 long, so 12.75. 12.75. There's my 12 3/4. Now I need to trim the end. Don't forget this step. This is very important on the door because we need it to be square. Now I can actually cut them both at the same time, or you can do one at a time. It's completely up to you. Get all the sawdust out of the way. Now I have to duck down and make sure they're both a little past the halfway where the blade comes up. Okay, so now that end is square. I move it down to the other side and cut again. All right, so there's my leftover. So those are done. Now the others are 9 3/4. 9 3/4. 9.75. And I have to do the same procedure, chopping the ends off first. I get them lined up and then push them both in. There. Okay, slide them all the way down and then cut them again right there. And there's my leftover pieces. Now you do not have to do them both at the same time. It's completely up to you which one you prefer. Bring your pieces to the big round shaper table. Now we're going to be using shaper number 1. It's labeled right here. It says rail and cutter. So here's how you prep for your shaper cuts. Figure out which faces you like best. Now these have pretty good faces on all of them. There's a knot on that one. Okay, so I like these faces right here. Take the time to take a pencil and put an X on the best side. Those are the ones that I like the best. And this is really important because if in one cut you flip it over to do the other, you've got to start all over. So your first cuts, only with the short ones. We're going to move the long ones out of the way for the moment. Number one, X down. The X must be down on every cut on this table. And we're going to use a number of shapers to make this door. So X is down. We are cutting end grain here, the short end. Now you're going to need a backing board, which is right here, to keep the tear out from happening. So I'm going to cut, flip it around, cut. Resist the temptation to lift it up and look. That's where you make the mistake of flipping it over. X is always down. Flip it around, do it again. Then we're going to do the exact same cuts on the other short one. X down, no sawdust underneath. Remember, I'm not holding it way out here. I'm holding it close to the blade. For the same reason, I need it down tight. And now we're done. So now I've cut both ends of only the short ones, and that's all I'm going to do on this shaper. For the next one, we're going to move on and do an edge on with the power feeder that's just right next to it. Now we simply shift over to the left slightly. We're at shaper number two. I know it's hard to see, but it says rail style edge. So now we're going to do an edge. But this one right here, I have to cut out a cathedral shape on the bandsaw. So we can't do the edge on this, not yet, not until we cut that off. So I'm going to lay that aside. We're going to do the other three. So we're going to do one edge on all three, and this is the inside edge where the panel's going to go. Again, X must be down. If you have it upside down, you'll have to remake your piece. So there's two things to turn on with this power feeder. Right on top here, you want to turn the knob clockwise to number one. That's the slow speed going that way. And then I'll turn on the machine and it'll pull it through and do it for you. However, I want to keep my hand holding it against the fence until I hit the edge of the feeder so that it doesn't come away. Once in a while, it'll pull away from the fence and you got to run it again. So push it in and kind of hold it. Now the next one, there's my X. X is down. Make sure there's no sawdust under it. And then same on that one. Very good. Now, when this is all done, the thing that should fit, this is the edge and the end that we did on the first run, they should bank together nice and tight like that. So there's very little give. If I go over this a few too many times or run this through too many times, there'll be a lot of slop in there. But this is a good fit. Now we can work on that cathedral part. So here at the bandsaw, we're going to cut out that cut, but I need something to follow. I need a line. Back in the back where the shapers are, you're going to have a pattern that looks like this. Okay? It's got some boards all the way around it, so your piece will fit inside. It has two screws where the tips come out, so it'll hold on to it. Very similar to the base trim we did earlier. Now, X down. And this happens a lot where students have it the wrong way, where they pick it up and put it in like this, and that's upside down, but they don't realize it because it's in their hands. X down, this fits in. It should only fit in one way, and it should be fairly tight, so that doesn't come out. Take your pencil, trace the line, make it nice and dark. Now, like on your base trim, you want to stay away from that line. I want to make sure that the blade is cutting off of the line. Do not prove how good you are on the bandsaw and get as close as you can. I want you off the line because we're going to use a shaper to cut the rest. So there's no reason to get that close. So turn it on. And I'm staying about an eighth of an inch away. So I didn't actually cut anything here or here, which is fine. The shaper will do the rest for me. The last step on this piece is this shaper bit. Now I've got two of them that don't have a guard around it. This is the one on the right, the one closest to the power feeder that we just used a second ago. This again has a bearing on the top that will ride along this pattern and shave off all the extra that's sticking out. Now in this case, it's also going to put a profile on it that we want so that we can fit it together. So we open up the gate, and again, X down and put this on exactly how you had it before, and it should hold it nice and tight. Turn it on and we go from the right to the left. But remember, start here off of your piece that you're cutting. If you start in here, it'll want to jerk. It'll want to pull it across real fast. So take your time and hold it down tight. Put the corner into the bearing until the bearing stops, and then work it across. And that's it. It doesn't take a lot of pressure. Be very careful. That's still spinning and there's no guard on it. But now when I take it off, now I have the proper profile on here that I need to put the panel inside like the rest.